Hello and welcome to another episode for Witcher 3. I'm actually doing this episode because I found how to use the figurine you actually win in the auction house. Didn't know how to break it, but I'll just show you now. You go to a crafter.
Willing to craft something for...
Put the dismantle. Find the figurine here, and as you can see, there is a maybe there's a map or something, and a key. See what we got. So Count Romilly's will to Robert, my son. To receive this package, it means your father has departed this vale of tears. I know we have no contact for many years, but I hope the contents of the chest opened by the key included within this will in some small way compensates for all the lost time. You'll find the chest in the underground quarters of our family home, Argstrone Castle. Your loving father, Count Walter May Romilly. Pretty weird name, I actually have to say. So let's go there and see what we can find. Maybe some nice treasure. Dark egg, I guess. Actually, I kind of know where this is, in the castle with the where we fought the Lashen. Lashen was near it. In the underground, there were some ghosts and. Was a chest where we couldn't interact with it, actually. Yes, I think this. Let me just put some oils up. Vectors or something else. I'm guessing the Lashen isn't here. I'm getting a little bit of that spooky sound. Guess it's not here. Guess, and I'm almost sure it's that chest. Really aren't many chests that don't open. With the exception of one, I know there is one locked chest. There's no key for it in game. Probably here. Yes, yes, look. The one. And a little bit of disappointment. It's that amazing, actually. Well, the ruby dust costs quite a lot, though. That's about it. Well, this is a pretty short video. Actually, I got all the. I paid to get all three layers of enchantment, and I think I'll just show you that. And a little bit of my thoughts on the four tier ones. I have to say, most of them are not all that amazing. And yes, they're a bit disappointing. As I said before, most people still use the for the chest. For me, I got the deflection one. The deflection pretty good against humanoids. And the talent, I still have it. But it's pretty hard to actually deflect the arrow back to actually do the damage. And I'd rather just have this on my chest. And this is how it looks. And all of the stuff is in place.
The world's never ending.
Also, another very interesting thing I didn't notice at first is that this guy, he can. And he's actually a master crafter and a weapon master crafter. I mean for the armor and the weapons. I actually got the Viper set. I wanted to craft this as well. I actually crafted all the sets this time around. I played from level 1. I actually gonna show you the Ophiri set. I crafted that. Didn't craft this one because I'm level 38 at the moment, and the level for this set is unfortunately 49. Oh, my cat just ran off. The only interesting bonus for this set is some resistance to poison. That's about it. No actually bonuses for attack. And the poison resistance, I don't fight in all that good, since you have a golden aureole, and if you have the superior one, actually when you get poisoned, you regenerate health. So why would you need this? I don't know. Who knows? I don't. So to the enchantment sword ones. I'm actually gonna preface this a little bit. I actually, when I upgraded all the swords, I had these swords on Superior, and I actually placed Severance on them. I know if you place runes, you don't actually use it. You don't actually lose the runes when you upgrade to higher tiers. But with enchantments, unfortunately, it's not so. You actually lose the enchantment. So be very careful with that. I guess the enchantment don't cost all that much. You can find the money to get them, but just a warning. I actually ran around a little bit with that runes were enchantment. So like get the level 3 one. Replenishment. After you cast a sign, an adrenaline point is consumed and your next sword attack is charged with the power of that sign. This one I think is really good. Well, at least it sounds good on paper. Actually, when I'm gonna play the next expansion, I think I'm gonna respect to the caster build. I really wanna try this one. Actually, kinda curious why it's not this for the... Next one, Invigoration. Is the only enchantment at level 3 that is fighting. But at maximum vitality, any vitality regeneration turns into added damage up to 10% on your next strike. Not exactly sure what how this 50% is calculated, because when you regen, most things that give you regen are in whole numbers, not percentages. And I actually noticed that you have a new rune, which at the highest tier it gives 3 points of health regeneration per rune. I actually tried testing a little bit of the light armor bonus, basically. Viral, and I didn't like it all that much. I had the runes on all the slots besides the I think wasn't regening all that fast. Maybe if you combine it with a swallow, maybe you can actually get enough points to make this profile. Who knows, maybe next expansion we will add a bit more enchantments. I think it really needs a lot more enchantments. Oh, this is for the sword. Sorry. Yes. I was thinking about replenishment here. I mean. So the last one, each unblocked blow increases potion duration time by 0.5 seconds. Actually, this one, I find it pretty good if you don't actually want to spec like me, going a little bit on the green tree to make yourself a bit more tanky. You do it like I did, or maybe go even more points, you'll have enough duration on your potions that you don't actually need this one. But for a sword, the spec, I actually think it'd be very, very good. The potions don't last. 0.45 for a heavy build. I'm not sure it's gonna be that amazing, but probably for a wheeler build, it's probably gonna be decent. For the armor ones, retribution gives a 30% chance of returning only a portion of the damage received by the attacker. Not sure how good this is. I wanted to test it out, and I'm probably gonna do this. Not sure when I'm gonna find the time to do it, but I really want to see if it's better than the decoction. I think it's the arch lesion, I think it is. I tried the decoction long ago and it wasn't all that amazing. Probably this one is, but at a 40% for only a portion of the damage. Not sure if it's all that good, because I don't like to get hit a lot anyway. So the next one, levity. All equipped armor items are treated as light armor. I actually don't know why all this the level 3 one is light armor, the level 2 one is medium armor, and the level 1 is for heavy. I would have placed all of this on the first tier of achievements. I don't think this should be so high up. But maybe again, who knows? From what I understand, the light bonuses are very sought after, so yeah, that's why. Position. When an opponent influenced by Axe dies, the effect transfers to the nearby target. Effect duration increases by 2 seconds for each blow the affected target lands. Basically what this is, this enchantment, and no, the patient. Basically this and the beguilement put together and a little bit of another bonus, and we all form one bonus or one singular bonus. Actually, I found it pretty good. When I started the first, when I did my first playthrough, I actually started backing into casting an actually Axie. I really wanted to make an Axie build, but unfortunately, the problem is when you the fights where there's a lot of enemies. Most of the enemies are kind of agile, and you don't actually get to possess them. Since possession takes a little bit of time, is the enhanced version of the Axie sign. But who knows, maybe some people get a good draw out of it. It looks very good on paper actually. But the thing is, with bosses, you still have to rely on your Igni and the Irden. I think the Irden is a must have for a caster build. So all done with that, I'm gonna go to town and show you the
thanks, so long.
Ophiri set. Ophiri set is basically a light armored set, but it has caster stats on it. It's a bit weird. The thing is, you will have to enchant your chest. Switch it to medium if you want to get that Griffin battle training, I think it's called. One that gives set bonuses for casting. And yeah, you lose those 3 slots. It's not very good. This is in my opinion. Why is the game freezing a little? That's weird. So where is it? Get a chest. Legs and lots.
No discount.
So. Well, since my camera is unfortunately covering a little bit of the screen, I'll just show you the set life. Has a little bit of an oriental influence on it. It looks quite nice actually. I would actually wear it instead of the Griffin one. I think it's the set that looks the worst out of the all the four sets. Well, this is its set as well, but it's a bit more centric. So, the thing about this armor, as you can see in the gloves and boots, it has one extra slot. I think it's to catch up, just so if you want a bonus, you have to enchant the body armor and get the medium all armor, and then can you have these two extras. Place some runes in it. I'm not sure if that makes up for the loss though. Well, anyway, when the next expansion is out, I'll probably gonna play a more caster focused build. I'm not sure when the new expansion is gonna be out, but then again, tomorrow Fallout 4 is out. And I'm gonna be busy with that, and I can't wait. I'm very excited. I'm a big Fallout fan. I'm probably gonna talk that when I'm building my character, just so it doesn't get all boring. Well, until then, I'm not sure if I have anything else to do in Witcher. Just gonna have to wait for the expansion. So, I'll be very grateful if you leave me a comment. Maybe a like, maybe a subscribe. It's all up to you. See you on my next video. Goodbye, guys.